Top story, House Democrats broke through an impasse voting to pass the blueprint for Biden's $3.5 trillion infrastructure plan and send it to its next impasse in the Senate. Here's House Speaker Nancy Pelosi just before eating a $10,000 pint of ice cream.
Today is a great day of pride for our country and for Democrats. We have a president with a big, bold vision for our country, an unprecedented opportunity to keep our promises for the people.
Pelosi overcame an intra-party revolt from moderates concerned that supporting the bill would signal to their Democratic base that they are Democrats. Congressman, is this a done deal? You're just fresh coming from the vote. Are there still House members holding out till they score one more mention in Political Playbook?
Well, this is really a vote to begin the process of marking up the $3.5 trillion Build Back Better bill, which is going to bring more jobs for Americans. It's going to lower taxes for middle-class Americans. And, you know, basically it's going to lower costs for things like drugs and medicines.
Moderately useful legislation making its way through Congress is a disturbing development. I can't help but fear our entire universe has strayed onto an alternate timeline where drawbridges aren't suspended by fishing line.
Moving on, as America's August 31st Afghanistan evacuation deadline approaches, President Biden is somehow rejecting calls to keep the good vibes going for just a few more weeks.
We agreed that we will continue to close cooperation to get people out as efficiently and safely as possible. We are currently on a pace to finish by August the 31st.
I don't know why Biden can't get this right. Surely evacuating tens of thousands of people was as easy as sitting on TV saying he should get this right.
Yes, if Brigadier General Jake Tapper were president, he would have totally nailed this.
And leave time to draw more cartoons. Now, Congressman, our G7 allies are not happy with the way this has been handled. Is this hurting Biden's chance of winning the 2024 election for Prime Minister of the UK?
He's president of the United States.
Our fact checker is fired.
I think he's really interested in becoming Prime Minister of the UK. I don't know that anybody believed that the Afghan government would fall so precipitously and so fast and so quickly.
I did.
What didn't happen overnight is our stay in Afghanistan. It's been 20 years that we've been there. I think most Americans believe that we needed to get out of Afghanistan.
I'm just shocked by all of this. You think a tidy war would have a tidy ending?
Hey, look, the United States military should think about doing some night flights. You can get a lot of work done on a red eye.
Amazing, Austin. It's amazing that's where your head went.
And stretch your legs mid-flight, everybody.
And now, an update on our explosive tuning out the news investigation into Republican gubernatorial candidate Andrew Giuliani of New York, seen here in a photorealistic recreation. Last month, we exposed that on Andrew Giuliani's campaign website, he falsely claimed to be the CEO of Giuliani Golf, and when confronted, erased it from his website. It gives me no pleasure to report that we busted the political wunderkind again, this time for embellishing his charity work, including in one case what appears to be an outright fabrication. On his official campaign website, Andrew Giuliani claims he has been involved in helping a charity known as the First Tee. The First Tee tells us, and this is real, we are not aware of any affiliation between First Tee and Andrew Giuliani. Andrew Giuliani appears to be pawning off competing in charity golf tournaments as actual charity work. For example, on his official campaign website, Giuliani also claims he has been involved in helping United Cerebral Palsy, which is true. He helped them help him have a great day on the greens. The organization tells us they can confirm that Andrew Giuliani participated in the UCP of NYC golf tournament several years ago, donating his time to support the organization. In Giuliani's defense, his time is really valuable considering his busy schedule of racking his brain for things he's already done that can be confused as charity work. And sometimes Giuliani's not even playing real golf. His campaign website also claims he has been involved in helping the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. An archive page 6 report from 2009 says, "We hear that Andrew Giuliani and other golf bros will play miniature golf against amateurs tonight on 27 holes set up at the Crown Plaza Hotel in White Plains to benefit the Leukemia and Lymphoma Societies." America, can you imagine a contribution as invaluable as getting to watch Andrew Giuliani play mini golf? In other words, can you imagine anything but that? The Giuliani campaign did not respond to 2 emails and a text message asking for comment, presumably because they're busy donating their time to a charity that lets a ball-peen-headed fail son play act as a viable candidate for governor. Now, Congressman, given this expansion of the definition of the concept of donating, are there any charities you'd like to take credit for supporting in the past?
No, I don't like to take things I take credit for things that I have nothing to do with.
And sounds like someone's bad
I'll just
at golf.
Say that it appears that Andrew Giuliani has as much of a struggle with the truth and forthrightness as his father. And let's just say the apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
Apple doesn't fall far from the tree also describes Rudy's dating strategy.
Giuliani is exaggerating, but I absolutely am not when I say I spent 5 minutes in the ball pit. So I'm a big supporter of the Ronald McDonald House.
Now look, I played in that mini golf tournament with Andrew, and I'd estimate it was a $1 million contribution to see how perfectly he hit the ball into the little door on the windmill statue on his third try.
Andrew Giuliani, you are, of course, welcome to address these mounting questions at any time on this show, Big News. We promise to get your incisors completely in frame.